fresh from being sown as MK Party MP in Parliament, Umkhonto weSizwe Secretary General Arthur Zwane has tendered his resignation from the party with immediate effect. Now, one will say it really doesn't make sense. Like, honestly speaking, it really doesn't make sense. And let me explain why I'm saying it really doesn't make sense. If, for instance, I'm thinking about the timing of the resignation here, and I'm saying to myself, does it make sense? You know what I'm saying? Why will the man get voted in as soon as his as soon as he's sown in as an MK Party? Suddenly, he then tender his resignation before he could even assume his responsibility. The question is why? But again, MK Party has quickly replaced him, right? In a sudden turn of events, Arthur Zwane, the Secretary General of Umkhonto weSizwe Party, has resigned after barely 2 months in the key position. Zwane cited a huge volume of work in the Secretary General's office as having forced him to arrive in his decision. Right, but they have replaced him. Don't worry. So we're gonna go through the resignation, but at the same time, we're also gonna go through the replacement. Right. It just present some of the questions to say, when Malema said, every new political party will suffer a lot of things, and then he's like, Nati as EFF, we have our fair share. Such words they come to pass now. Ugoti Asia. It is true when they say a political party is still subject to a lot of how can I call this? They are still subject to a lot of troubles, trials and tribulation until they get to the point where they stabilize. And then once they stabilize and then they have a leadership, and then that leadership is not a leadership that comes and go. But even with the ANC, you have people resigning there. It's just that because it's an old political party, the resignation are not many. Yeah, are not many, unlike a new political party like MK Party. Nonetheless, let's start with the one of the person who resigned before we talk about the one who has been who has replaced him. But before we can even go there, this is what we need to do first. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. In his letter to party leader Jacob Zuma, Zwane cited overlook and business interest as a reason for his decision to relinquish his duties on full-time servant of the party. Okay. Zwane was one of the 58 leaders of the party who were sown during a ceremony held in Parliament last Tuesday. So one question that I have to ask is, in this case, what do we do? As a party, when one of your person get, just after being sown in, they resign, does it necessarily mean that they get to they get to do, look, you must find somebody else to be sewn in. I think I need to follow up. On the last 2 weeks, I have realized that the volume of work in my office is huge and beyond my limits, especially because I have other competing business interests that I am pursuing. I am humbled by the confidence you had in me. Starting from being a DSG and later SG, I will be available to hand over the new appointment SG at a determined time, Zwane said. Right? But so far, this resignation, you know, it doesn't sound hostile-like. It just sounds like, hey, you know what? I'm coming to this point. I'm resigning, but not in bad faith, in good faith, because I will be available should you guys want me. I like that. Yeah? Zwane indicated in his letter that he was willing to help with organization matter on a part-time basis. Again, it then shows that, okay, this person is still available in the party, is not necessarily leaving MK. He's not resigning as an MK member. He's resigning from the office. I will also be available to help with other organizational matters you want me to help with. However, I look, not on full-time basis, which is, for me, I think it's fair. It's fair to have a person who says, I'm available if you want me, but not on a full-time basis. Okay? Though I think the question will be, why wouldn't you tell us on time? On the other news, then, it was reported that MK Party has quickly replaced him in the it was announced that on Tuesday that Sifiso Masego will replace Zwane with immediate effect. Masego was MK Party's treasurer general. So now he is going to replace him there. For me, I think those are some of the problems that you are bound to face as a new political party, because, I mean, come on, come to think of it, it's starting, so the overload is bound to happen. The overload is just bound to happen. It's just something else. It's a fact. The overload is bound to happen. Until this organization gets to a point where it is sitting comfortably and now it has established itself, it now understands itself. Because a lot of people now would have joined the party as well, not understanding the party, not knowing what the party wants, not understanding where the party is going. You know what I'm saying? So when they learn and realize that, oh, the party is taking this direction and the job keeps just piling up, then they were like, oh, thank you very much. I know this one is not for me. So we are yet to see things like that in the party. But I'm very happy. You know, when people resign in good faith, saying, no, I'm available to help. That, for me, yeah, that alone speaks volume to me. Such people I can keep. Tell me if you can no longer do it. Tell me if you have lost the zeal for it. But at the same time, when you say to me, I'm available to help anytime, you touch just, I'm a phone call away, I will be able to assist. I'm super impressed by such. So it's not like a big deal to say, oh, there are big problems in the party, blah, 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 before this enemies makes a big deal out of it. Like I said it to you guys that, Julius Malema did say that MK Party will have their fair share of problems, of leadership, of this and this and this and this and squabbles and everything. But later on, they will eventually overcome that. And Julius Malema said that EMK Party, EFF, they had their fair share in such problems where this one said this, this one did this, this one did that, and they are pulling towards different direction, yet they are building this thing. But it gets to the point where, in fact, I spoke to one person who said to me, MK Party, they are about to face that. And he said this way before Malema said it. So it's not necessarily a new thing, the challenges that they are going through. Well, those challenges, they are bound to happen. Especially if you are a political party on their caliber. Well, you are to accept that. So What's your take about the new changes that are coming out of MK Party? Personally, I'm not scared. I didn't go like, oh, what's going on at MK Party? No, I was like, oh, okay, something like that is happening. Okay, yeah, it's bound to happen.